science in a dosa. Every morning, without fail, my three-year-old wakes up and says,
Amma, I want dosa.
It's a ritual in our South Indian home.
Golden, crispy dosa, fresh off the pan.
Or beautiful, soft, flower-like neel dosa.
Whatever way she likes it.
One morning, while I was pouring the batter onto the pan, she watched with curious eyes. She asked, Amma, why does the pan need to be hot to cook dosa? I smiled. Now that's a science question. When the pan is hot, the batter sets quickly and starts cooking. That's how it becomes crispy. If the pan is cold, the batter just sits there and turns soggy. She nodded thoughtfully and said, Ah, dosa needs heat. Just like we need the sun. Exactly, I said. Then came another question. Why do we add salt, Amma? Well, I said, it's for taste, but also to balance the fermentation. Remember how we saw bubbles in the batter? She peeked into the vessel. Look, Amma, bubbles, pop, pop, she said. That's because tiny invisible helpers called bacteria and yeast are working hard. They make the batter rise and create air in the batter.
That's science. She whispered, eyes wide. There are bugs in the dosa?
I laughed. Yes, but good bugs. They help us. Just like tiny chefs inside the batter. She giggled. But not every dosa day is perfect. One time, I accidentally added too much water to the batter. The dosa just wouldn't come off the pan. It stuck, tore, and turned mushy. My daughter looked at it and said, Amma, why is it not working today? I sighed. Because the batter is too watery, Maga. It needs the right thickness to come off the pan. If it's too thin, it won't hold together. That's called consistency. She thought for a second and said, So dosa needs to be strong? Yes, I said, laughing. Strong enough to hold itself, but soft enough to cook well. That way, we talked about heat, fermentation, texture, and consistency, all while flipping a dosa. No textbooks, no labs, just a curious little girl and her breakfast. Because sometimes the best science lessons happen in the kitchen.